A warm welcome to all my dear 5th standard children. Today we are going to learn about your final topic from your science subject. Yes, of course, this is your last chapter from your science subject. So what is your 14th chapter? The 14th chapter is about our environment. Okay, so today we are going to learn about environment. What are the factors that affect the environment, and we are going to learn how we can save our environment, right? So in this lesson, first thing you have to learn about pollution. What is pollution? So pollution is nothing but any harmful changes that happens in the environment that affects the living organisms. So what is pollution? In your 2 marks, they may ask, right? So define pollution. So the definition of pollution is the harmful changes brought in the environment by human activities are called pollution. So only human activities cause the pollution, right? So no animals or plants are going to pollute the air or pollute the soil, right? So only because of humans, only the air, the environment is getting polluted, right? So when there is a change in the environment due to some harmful changes, due to some effects, so that is known as pollution. So pollution is the first cause of changes of environment. So the environment is affected by the pollution, right? So in this pollution, there are 4 types of pollution. So air pollution, water pollution, land pollution, or we can also call it as soil pollution, and noise pollution. So these are the 4 types of pollution, right? Now let's see, when the pollution happens in the air, when the air is getting polluted is known as air pollution. And when the water bodies like lakes, rivers, ponds, sea gets polluted, it is known as water pollution. And land, when the soil is getting polluted or when we dump more amount of waste in the soil, so chemicals, so thereby it causes land pollution. And when there is loud noise or a loud noise from vehicles or factories, running of machines, so these also cause noise pollution. Now let's see how these pollutions are caused. So first we will see about air pollution. How air pollution is caused? So air pollution is caused by smoke from factories, industries and vehicles. So we can see when there is industries or factories, when they run, so they give out more amount of smoke. So this smoke is full of carbon dioxide, so thereby it pollutes the air. And also the smoke from the vehicles. So when the vehicles run, they give out more amount of smoke. So because of the smoke from the vehicles, smoke from the factories, and not only this, when we burn out wood, when we burn out waste materials, or when we burst the crackers, so we give out more amount of smoke, right? So thereby the smoke pollutes the air. So this, when the air is getting polluted, we cannot able to take in a pure air, right? Our health becomes a problem, right? So this is about air pollution. Now let's see how the water pollution is caused. So water pollution is caused by release of household waste in water from the waste water from industries and factories. So these waters or released into the water bodies. Maybe it can be a pond, or it can be a lake, or it can be a river, or it can be a sea also. So when we give release more amount of waste, or when we put more amount of solid waste into the water bodies, the water body is getting polluted, right? So this is how the water pollution is caused. The next thing is land pollution. So how the land pollution is caused? When we dump out more amount of waste on the soil, so thereby the soil is getting polluted, right? And when we put more amount of waste like chemicals or plastics, or it can be a non-biodegradable waste. So the soil is getting polluted, thereby it causes land pollution and usage of fertilizers. So once we use fertilizer, chemical fertilizers for the plants to grow, this fertilizers also pollute the soil. So these are all the things that will cause the land pollution. So then the final one is about noise pollution. How noise pollution is caused? So noise pollution is caused by loud noise from the machines, from the vehicles. So mostly in the traffics and all, you can hear more amount of noise, right? Always horn sound, everything, you, and running of machines inside industries. So these things cause noise pollution. Now, so today you have learned about the pollution and different types of pollution, how they are caused, right? So now let's see about greenhouse. What is greenhouse? So greenhouse is nothing but a house which is made of glass. So usually our house is made of wood or cement or bricks or sand like that, right? Is it? But here this house is made of glass. So you can see here the walls of the greenhouse are made of glass. Why it is made of glass? Why? Because in some hilly areas or in some places, the plants cannot able to get the proper carbon dioxide. They cannot able to prepare the food from the air, right? Because of less amount of carbon dioxide, as well as the because of the cool climate. So to keep the plants warm, the plants are kept inside a greenhouse. So here in this greenhouse, the sun gives out the heat. So this heat enters into the greenhouse, but the heat, once it enters into the greenhouse, it will not escape from the greenhouse. So the heat is present inside the greenhouse itself. So thereby it is good for the plants to grow, and also the plants will prepare their own food, right? So this greenhouse, this glass walls absorb the heat, but they will not give out the heat out of the house. So that's why the greenhouse is made up of glass walls, right? So here you can see the greenhouse is specifically made, you can see in botanical gardens, in nursery places and all, you can see this type of house, right? So this is known as greenhouse, right? Now why it is called as greenhouse? Why? Because there are some gases that is present in the atmosphere. So this gases keep the atmosphere warm. So that is why these gases are called as greenhouse gases. Why? Because they have the property of trapping heat. So they can able to absorb. The nature of the greenhouse gases is to absorb heat, and thereby they can withhold the heat. That's why, because of the greenhouse gases, the earth is warm. Without the greenhouse gases, the earth will become very cold, where we cannot able to live. Otherwise, our earth will become like a freezer box. How a freezer box looks like, the same way our earth will become like that if the greenhouse gases are not present. Okay. Now let's see, what are the greenhouse gases? We know that atmosphere, that is air, is a mixture of gases, right? And in that we know about nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, all that. But what are these greenhouse gases? So these greenhouse gases are carbon dioxide, water vapor, ozone and methane. So here you can see carbon dioxide, methane, ozone. These are all some greenhouse gases. So mainly you can keep it in mind as carbon dioxide, water vapor, ozone, methane. So these gases have the property of trapping heat. So these gases can able to hold the heat. So thereby, if the gases are present, that place will be very hot. For example, you can just keep your finger under your nose. You can just exhale the air. So how the air you can feel, whether the air that you are giving out, whether it is cold or hot, it will be hot, right? Yes, because you are exhaling carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide is a warm gas, right? So same way, carbon dioxide, water vapor, ozone, methane are warm gases. They keep the place warm, right? So these are called as greenhouse gases. Now let's see about greenhouse effect. What is greenhouse effect? So greenhouse effect is nothing but, so as the sun give out more amount of heat to the earth, right? So more amount of heat is coming to the earth. Some heat are absorbed by the earth, but some heat are escaping into the space, right? They are reflecting back into the space. When they are reflecting back, the greenhouse gases that is present in the atmosphere will trap the heat, and thereby it will keep the earth warm. And some heat is escaped, some heat are trapped by the greenhouse gas. So this is known as greenhouse effect. So because of the greenhouse gases that trap the heat, so the earth is warm, right? So this effect is known as greenhouse effect. Without the greenhouse gases, the earth will become very cold, where we cannot be able to live. Now this is about greenhouse effect. Suppose if there is more amount of greenhouse gases increases, for example, when we use more, or when we burn waste, when we burn wood, or when we cut down all the trees after deforestation, so the amount of carbon dioxide in the air increases. So once the carbon dioxide level increases, definitely the earth will become very, very hot, is it? Because the carbon dioxide have the property of trapping heat. So this earth will become very, very hot, where we cannot able to live for a longer time. We will we need some cold place, right? So how the greenhouse gases are increasing? So because of pollution, because of smoke, and because of usage of some gases. What are the gases? There is a gas that is used in air conditioners, refrigerators, which is known as chlorofluorocarbons. So chlorofluorocarbons, that is CFC. So this gas is present in air conditioners and refrigerators. So this gas can able to increase the greenhouse gases. Once we use more amount of refrigerators, more amount of air conditioners, the amount of CFC gas will increase. So thereby the greenhouse gases also increase, thereby the warm of the earth will also increase, right? So it is very, very important to maintain the greenhouse gas. The greenhouse gases should not be less or should not be more also. So we have to maintain that. How we can maintain this? How, what are the measures that we can take this? So when the greenhouse gases increases, so that is known as global warming. So if the greenhouse gases increases in the air, in the atmosphere, the earth will become very, very hot, right? So this is known as global warming. The globe is becoming very, very warm. So suddenly, slowly, what happens? The temperature of the earth increases, and thereby the earth becomes very, very warm. So that is known as global warming. And what are the effects of global warming? Because of the global, once the earth becomes very, very hot, the in the polar regions there is full of icebergs, right? So there will be melting of icebergs. Because of the melting of icebergs, there will be increase in the sea level, right? So these are the effects. And also there will be changes in the climate. So suddenly it will be hot, suddenly it will be there will be rain. So there will be on and off, there will be changes in the climate, and there will be melting of icebergs. So the icebergs will start to melt, and suddenly there will be rises in the sea level. The sea level becomes increases, okay? And in low-lying areas, there will be floods. So these are all the effects of global warming. Now, how we can control, how we can take steps against the global warming? So first thing is, we should reduce the use of fossil fuels. So like using more amount of coal, petroleum, So when we should avoid using those fossil fuels, because the amount of coal and petroleum nowadays it is becoming decreasing, right? So we should reduce the usage of coal, petrol and all, and use electricity wisely. We have to use the electricity wisely. Unnecessarily we should not switch on the, we should not use the electricity. And use public transport or carpooling. So instead of going in a separate, making arrangements in a separate vehicle, if we use a bus or train, so we can avoid pollution also, we can avoid the fuel usage also. And always try this 3 R's, that is reduce, reuse and recycle. Next, plant more trees. So when we plant more trees, the trees will take up all the carbon dioxide, thereby the amount of carbon dioxide decreases and thereby we can control the global warming. Next, switch to clean energy sources like solar energy, wind energy. So instead of using fuel energies, we can switch on to solar energy or wind energy. We can convert solar energy into electrical energy or wind energy into electrical energy. So once we use this type of thing, we can control the global warming, right? So this is about the measures that should be taken against global warming. So in this session, you have learned about what are the problems that environment face. So first thing is about pollution, and the next thing that you learned is about greenhouse effect, and you also learned about global warming and how we can check and measure the control the global warming, right? So hope this is our earth. So the earth is our environment, so we have to keep our environment safe. So it is not only human beings live in this environment, even plants, animals, they also live in the earth, right? So they also live on the earth. So we have to save our planet, right? So hope you will all do that. So avoid using plastics mainly. So once we use more amount of plastics, that will also spoil the environment. So with this, I will complete this session. So in the next class, I will meet you with a new topic. So thank you for watching. Have a great day.